Hello, my name is Sandra. I am a privacy engineer in SandboxAQ. Actually, I lead the privacy team. In the privacy team, what we try to do is that we take care that this data is protected when we use it for our products, so that the privacy of the individuals that are going to use them is not compromised. I joined a career in STEM because I like technology, and I never thought that actually this technology would enable me to create things that impact at the society level. First of all, I started studying electrical engineering because actually I wanted to be a sound technician, and that was the closest career at university that I could choose. The way I discovered cryptography was at university. I had several lessons about the topic. Actually, I had a teacher that I liked really much. I liked the way he explained the topic. It's a really complex subject. But at the same time, once you start to understand it, it's like, wow, the things that you can do, no? It's about hiding information, and like you need to have like a secret in order to be able to reveal it, and also like you can protect it so that nobody can modify it and things like that. And for me, it was like really fun to learn all this stuff. So I continued that path, and I work in like electronic voting. Then I also worked more general in security in several companies. And then I started hearing about SandboxAQ and the pioneer work that they were doing. So I just wanted to join. Sometimes when people think about STEM programs, they think about maths, about software development, but these are like very abstract concepts, no? In fact, you can use maths in order to solve multiple problems. And for example, one of the problems is the problem of data protection. Now that at the end, it turns out to be how we protect our privacy from all the, for example, all the devices that we have in our pockets, in our home, that are actually gathering the data from us, no? In that sense, I think that it is really important that there are more and more programs related to privacy and to cryptography and security. A thing that I think is very cool from the SandboxAQ is that there's a strong learning background. So people are encouraged to learn new things all the time. And there are like talks about different topics people are working on. There are also a lot of learning resources, and also I try to make use of that as much as I can. One project I am particularly proud of, actually, well, it's something that happened at the start of my career. The first company I worked on was a company that were doing products for electronic voting through the internet. And I was really happy and proud of working in those kind of projects where at the end we were making the technology work for like improving the rights of the people, no, being able to exercise their democracy. And yeah, for me that purpose was really, really important and engaging. One of the reasons I also joined SandboxAQ is because I think we have a similar purpose now of like creating technologies that are going to have this really big impact in people, no? So I am looking for like this kind of opportunities. Of course, giving visibility to the women that are in this field is really important. Also, I think that it is really critical to reach to people like in very early stages. I mean, like in primary school, for example. I am part of a program in my city where we actually give some like. For the Girl in Science Day, we give talks in schools, in primary schools, and we talk about our jobs. And I think it's a way to engage girls and women from the beginning into these kind of careers. In my first job in cryptography and in security, there was a huge difference between the amount of men and women in a given department. Like, for example, we had a lot of women in the software engineering teams and also in the research team. My feeling is that I haven't seen that I was mistreated or that I was treated differently from my other colleagues for being a woman. But sometimes I think this is because I may not be aware of that. And this is something that also when talking with other colleagues, I realize that it is more and more important. Like, we are used sometimes of being the only woman in a room, and maybe we don't realize about the fact that maybe we are not being heard that much, but maybe we are seen as the exceptional case, no? And then you feel like that, and you think that's the rule, no? And it shouldn't be like that. you shouldn't be treated as an exception. A piece of advice that I would like to give to people, and especially women that are looking into getting into STEM fields, don't think that you cannot like do something. Just give yourself the opportunity to try it out. I think most of the impediments that we find are because of our attitude. And actually, if we keep our mind open and we really try with our best, we have more opportunities to achieve whatever we want.